Hey guys, so I would do my normal intro and everything, but I kind of want to keep this video short and serious because there's a lot going on right now. So you can probably tell from the title, this video is going to be about the delay of idle research and about why I am doing that. If you're not really interested in the story and you don't really care about me as a person, and you just want a quick explanation, I will provide that real quick. Essentially, the list of things that I need to get done is growing and the amount of time I have is shrinking, and that just doesn't work. And when that happens, my stress level increases and my anxiety level increases, and I begin to rush and I create crappy products, and I don't want that for idle research. So therefore, I am extending the game's release date to sometime in 2022. I have no idea when. It could be a month, it could be 2 months, it could be 6 months, it could be a year from now. We don't know. But I will say that it's gonna be sometime in 2022, and I'm not gonna be giving any more concrete dates until I am for sure knowing when it's coming out. And on top of that, I just have so much I need to get done. And currently it's finals week, so I already have a lot on my plate right now. And just on top of all that stress and everything I have to get done in such a short amount of time, it's just nearly impossible. Like, the game's supposed to be released in what, like less than a few weeks, and I still haven't even finished the cylinders layer yet. Not even close. I still have so much I need to get done, and there's just no way I can get it done by then. Anyways, that's the quick explanation. I will kind of go more into details if you are interested, and if you actually care about me and my feelings. So believe it or not, game development is fun, okay? So I will say, it's a lot of fun. You learn a lot of things, you learn a lot of tricks. You develop a lot of skills over time with game development. However, at the same time, it sometimes feels like a job when it's supposed to be like a hobby. And right now, I'm currently at the point where it kind of feels like a chore rather than a hobby that I enjoy. Don't get me wrong, I still enjoy work on idle research and game development in general, but just right now, just where I am in life right now, it just feels like a chore. And that just makes me uninterested. Not really uninterested, but like, if it's a chore, I'm gonna half-ass it. And I don't want that for you guys, because I have been working on this game for such a long time now, and I've been working very hard, and I want to create a great game that you guys will enjoy. I don't want to create a half-assed game that you guys are not gonna kind of enjoy. And that's just, one, a waste of my time. Two, that's a waste of your time. And three, that just gives me a bad impression and it makes me embarrassed. But to kind of go along with that, it's mental health, really. That's kind of a big reason behind this. Everyone feels stressed, anxious, depressed, lonely at times. We've all felt that. Well, I'm assuming most of us have felt that way, at least. I've definitely felt that a lot recently, and that's just because I'm overwhelmed. Simply, there's just a lot going on. I have just lots of stuff going on outside of the game development world, and I'm kind of just trying to work on myself and focus on the really important things, and that is, first of all, getting through school. Second of all, having a social life, because if I don't have a social life, then I'm gonna be lonely and even more depressed, and that just doesn't help. So I need to focus on those two areas and then kind of work on the game, right? So hopefully that makes sense. And if I can satisfy those two things, then I can satisfy the third thing, because I am happy and I am motivated and ready to work. So there's all the mental health and everything related to that. So I'm done talking about that. Let's talk about the game itself and like what's taking me so long. What is actually making my to-do list grow like crazy? So as I'm playing it, I am just jotting down new ideas to kind of just rebalance and revamp everything. Before I actually get into that, I'd like to talk about the refactorization. So basically, I spent a week completely refactoring my code, and it looks much better now than it did about a month ago. I did this about like a few weeks ago, but anyways, that's not the point. The point is that I basically had the same code for crafting, research, fire, ice, stuff like that for each layer, flasks, tubes, and cylinders. So there's a lot of copy and pasting, and it's just a lot of just mess. And it's really hard to manage. And if I'm gonna add more layers in the future, I'm gonna have to do the same thing over and over and over again. And it's very daunting. And that is also another reason why it was kind of stressing me out. It was just not fun. And another thing is that if I wanna add holiday events, this code refactoring is gonna help me a lot. It's gonna do a lot for me, so which is gonna be really nice. So that's, I spent a lot of time doing that, so it should help speed things up a little bit. However, I had to sacrifice some things. First of all, the save system. I had to redo it entirely. So that means any beta tester or anybody that's in the demo version right now, their saves are gonna be gone. But don't worry, I'm gonna provide a save bank for those kind of people. But anyways, that's not the point. The point is that I am just doing a lot to the game right now just to make it more stable and make it easier for me and just better for the long term. Another thing I had to sacrifice is the mastery tree in Flask Layer. So you probably have seen the preview on my channel before. I'm trying to remember if I actually made that video public or not. But anyways, there was a feature with an upgrade tree. I am ditching that just because it's the quality of life is really hard to kind of master and it's a waste of my time. So removing that feature has to get me brainstorming again, creating new ideas for Flask and seeing if I should provide it for all layers and stuff like that. And then that also comes down to rebalancing Flask again. So I'm in the middle of doing that, which takes a lot of time. So yeah, there's a lot kind of going backwards at this moment rather than actually moving forward and finishing cylinders. Another thing I'm planning on doing is redoing the adventure system. So currently, when the two, like the enemy and you, your player, when they fight, they have two different attack times. So I'm going to change this approach because it makes defense more useful. The approach I'm going for is a Trimps style, which is another idle game. Trimps, T-R-I-M-P-S, if you're curious, it's a cool game. But anyways, I'm kind of going for that style. So basically they're going to have the same attack speed. The normal player will attack first, but then instantly the next player will, the enemy will attack and it will keep going on. And this will just make defense more useful. So if I'm going to do that, a lot of balancing is going to be required because I'm going to have to make sure attack, max HP, regen, and defense is kind of equal now. So there's that. And now let's go to the little darker side of the game development, which people don't really like to talk about just because it's such a gray area. And that is monetization. So I am going to be including ads for mobile and in-app purchases. And I have yet to design those at all. Right now, there's just nothing in there. I'm completely balancing the game based off free to play. So people will, you know, won't get into a time wall and feel peer pressure to actually buy something. But anyways, I still have to design those and that's gonna take a long time as well. And along with that, marketing, so advertising. I have never advertised before. Well, not for a game at least, but I have for other things in the past. But anyways, the point is that there's a lot to learn. And if I'm gonna create ads from scratch, or if I'm gonna do research on search engine optimization, just stuff like that, it's gonna take a lot of time. And I can't just do that in a weekend. There's just no way. And I, as a broke college student, would like to make some money so I can actually have a better quality of life and eventually buy myself a car so I can drive, so I can commute during my sophomore, junior, and senior year, unless I buy an apartment, stuff like that. So again, I need money because I need to live as a broke college student that is severely in debt. Well, at least I will be. But so yeah, anyways, there's the gray area. The game will be free again. I've explained that many times, but yeah, if you're case or curious, the game's free. So I'd like as many people to play as possible. And yeah. So those are all the game related updates. I'm trying to think if there's anything else I should include. I guess I can talk about YouTube. So I haven't uploaded a YouTube video in a really long time. It was the 5K sub and then I'm gone, just like that. One, it's motivation, in all honesty. I just haven't really had the drive to make a video. I have some unedited videos, but I just, when I sit here at this desk, I'm just like, nah, I don't feel like editing it today. And that just repeats every day. I just haven't had the motivation to record a video, and I'm really sorry for those who are kind of just waiting on me for that. I promise I will at some point, hopefully over winter break when I'm back at home and I'm kind of just, you know, back in my normal routine, but we will see. So yeah, anyways, again, idle research will be delayed. I'm aiming sometime in 2022. I'm not gonna give any concrete dates until I actually know 1 month ahead of time, this game will be ready. And I need that kind of grace period to like be prepared and to mentally prepare for such a release, because we just hit 5,000 wishlists today as of the 13th of December, which is a lot of people. And that is something that kind of, you know, not my territory. So I got to mentally prepare. But I hope you guys all understand what's going on. And I hope you aren't too angry with me. I mean, it's a free game. You shouldn't really be mad at me. I mean, come on. I'm just a college student working on a free idle game. Come on, give me a break. But anyways, enough about me. I hope you guys are having a great day or night, whatever you're doing right now. And I will see you guys in a video at some point. Thank you very much for watching. I really appreciate everyone's support. I can't wait to see you guys in the next one. See y'all later. Peace.